What's up guys, Kamil here from Addictive Frames. In this video I'm going to show you how to make this classic pie chart in DaVinci Resolve. Also I prepared this in 3D space and hopefully that helped you to understand how layers work. So let's dive in. So this is my node tree, this is my composition I made for this animation. You can find link in the description below so you can download it and have ready composition if you don't want to follow me. Let's go back to edit page and let's find another fusion composition. I've got this in favorites in effects tab. So let's put it here and I need 52 frames for this composition. So I hit Ctrl D and type in 52. And as you can see, the length is the same. So let's jump into Fusion. We've got two windows. The right window will be for our final look of the composition, of our final animation. And I need to grab pie chart. I just made it in JPEG. So that will be reference. I can have a look. And let's start make our composition. So we've got background. As you can see, background is alpha 0. In my case, it is as a default. First, we're gonna start with this background on the back. So as you can see, this is a dent grid on the black background. So I'm going to effect. I've got prepared already saved this background. So you can copy my parameters. I don't wanna make it from scratch. Okay, let's connect it here. I hit 2 on merge. So as you can see, this background is gradient. This on the left color is black and on the right, the color is kind of like this. You can copy this hex code and I just move this background, move these lines. So it looks like that. Next, grid. You can copy these parameters and let's have a look at settings. So the blend is like that. And we've got node names dent. And this is the parameters you can copy. You can make it differently if you want to. It's up to you. Next, we're gonna start to make this pie chart, this wheel. I'll grab background with alpha 0. Another background will be white color with alpha up to 1. And I'm going to name it background white. Let's connect it to the main line. And what I'm going to do now, I'm going to hit Ctrl and G, clicking by this window before. And now I have guides that helps me to position everything in the correct place. So I've got white background. Now I'm going to drop ellipse here. I need to hit 2 on this merge and we've got ellipse and I'm going to position this ellipse around here. Actually, as you can see on the left, I can adjust to how I got on the left. It's in between these two lines. Okay, so we've got first circle and we're going to add text to this background, which is 25%. Okay, so I've got open sans and I need extra bold for that. Can type in 25% and I'm going to change color to red and I'm going to position here, same as on the left. Okay, cool. So we've got first layer of this wheel. Before we move to the next step, I want to name this ellipse. That will be ellipse white. And because of this will be animated, I want to make it stand out. So I'm going to make it bigger. That will be style node. And what I'm going to do now, I'm going to copy this ellipse. Okay, click in this empty space and hit Ctrl Shift V and I will have instance of this. And I'm going to click in this empty space as well and do the same Ctrl Shift V. And I've got another instance and I'm going to hit Ctrl Shift V here as well. And I've got 4 instances. And I will show you how it works soon. I'm going to copy as well this. Just copy no instances, Ctrl C and paste it here. I'm going to connect this ellipse to this white background and connect it here. And I'm gonna do the same here. So copy, paste, connect everything, connect this ellipse to the background and as well, paste it here, connect and this ellipse I connect here. And I'm gonna name every background and every ellipse that will go from the top. First layer is white, the second layer is purple. So I'm gonna name it purple. Purple, this ellipse will be, let's leave it instance ellipse purple. Next layer will be green one, instance ellipse green. And the last layer is blue, instance ellipse blue. Background will be blue as well. So, okay, so we've got prepared everything. And now what we need to do, we need to change colors, obviously. So that will be purple. So that will be this one. And that will be green. And let's have a look. Let's see, maybe this color, that was this color, I believe. Let's have a look. I think it's the same. Let's go back and blue one. That is, I think that was this one. Okay. and it shows up. Okay, and now I will try to explain you how layers work. From the left is first layer, which is white, this one. You can't see it on the right side because it is on the bottom. Next layer is purple and next layer is green. And on the top, you've got blue background, blue wheel. I prepared this wheel in 3D space and hopefully that helped you to understand how layers work. So let's go to Fusion. I've got this composition here. And as you can see, it's not the same size. It looks differently, but I hold Alt and scroll and I move it. And as you can see, this is how it looks like in the final result, how I prepared that. So as you can see, that's the first layer, that's the second, third, and the last one is blue. Based on this picture, you can visualize how it works. Okay, let's go back to our composition. And what can help you to understand this as well, as let's make it bigger. Let's turn out the inspector, make more space. From the left, so you've got the background, which is alpha zero. And on this background, that will go, I can show you even that. I can click two here, so that's the first layer, okay? And you know that it's on the top of this zero background, the alpha zero background, because this has got green arrow here, okay? So we've got first layer. This merge is on top of this layer because we've got green arrow here. And when I hit two, you've got another layer, you've got purple, and so on and so forth. Another one, if when I hit two, you've got green background, and I hit two here, you've got blue on the top. And this is what we see now all together. Hopefully that made more clear for you. Next, I'm going to frame 50. And before that, I forgot to prepare numbers. Here we've got, so let's come back to layer number two, which is purple. And I want to position the text here. And let's go to layer number three, which is green ellipse, and text will be here in this position. And last layer, which is blue one, blue wheel, I'm going to position this number here. And I need to name numbers as well. We're on frame 50, and now we need to animate this wheel. So we need to open them and close. So how to do that? We need to put expression here on border width. So type equal, enter, connect this to width, uncheck solid, and make sure you got cap style, this one, and by length, you can open this and close, okay? And now let's change position. So we want position, so we want start from here, that will be 0.25. Now it's going anti-clockwise, as you can see. And I want this to go clockwise. And to do that, I just type in minus one and come back. When I come back to zero, okay, when I'm in zero, so I can animate this to clockwise. On frame 50, that would 20%, let's say it's like that. And we need to de-instance a length of that, okay? That's the one thing we need to de-instance in all ellipses. So I'm going to de-instance length and I'm going to jump to this ellipse, which is green. And I need to de-instance this as well. And as you can see, that's come up from the bottom of the blue. So that needs to be 30%, that needs to be in the middle on the bottom. So it will be minus 0.5. And let's jump to purple one, the instance length. That will be minus 0.75. And white ellipse will be complete. Go to the left, that will stay on minus one. We'll leave it like that. Actually, we can hit the diamond here on each of this. When we are on frame 50, hit diamond here. And this one as well. And let's go back to number zero. Let's make more space here. And we need to animate each ellipse simply. You need to type zero in every length of each ellipse. And now when you hit play, it all looks like that. And I want these numbers to be, to reveal along with the circle, with the wheel, that they need to be inside in each color. And how to do that is very simple. So we need to just go to merge and make it a top and here as well, top. Every merge needs to be a top. And now, as you can see, it works. So we need to just move this animation, go to the spline editor and select all tools, make it bigger, select all of them, hit F and hit D, and I want to do it to 100, is into 100. Let's close, and it's smooth now, nice and smooth. Now we need to make this people colored. It's very simple. So I'm going to media pool, and I've got this in icon. You can find it in the description below, this asset, this icon. This is the person. It doesn't look good now, but it will be different. So I name it person, and let's prepare that background alpha. Connect this to, and before we go, let's tidy up here to the main node tree, and let's hit to here. And I want this to be white, so I need the background which will be white, and I connect this background to this merge and hit at top here, and we've got one white person, white icon. I need to hit 2. Let's go to frame 50. Now let's hit transform here and make it smaller. Let's now do duplicate, shift space, and type in duplicate. And I want 10 copies of that. Move center to the right, and we've got 10 persons. And now I grab this transform and move it a little bit to the left. And I want this wheel smaller. Let's actually hit any ellipse of that, and I can make it a bit smaller. And that's why I made instances, in case of that you decided later on to make it bigger or smaller. Otherwise, if that wouldn't be instances, then you would need to adjust every ellipse individually, and that would be pain in ass. Let's go back here, and we've got 10 of people, and I would like to make it a bit smaller as well. And now we're gonna hit shift space and drop another duplicate node, and I'm going to hit 10 copies, and I'm going to move center to down. And we've got 100 people. We need to make it smaller again. I can even name duplicate. That will be vertical, and this duplicate is horizontal. Let's move it up. And now we need to kind of colorize these icons. White ones will be 25%. So if it's 100 people, we need 25% of them remain white. So how am I gonna make it? I'm going to copy this white background, hit Ctrl C, and again I'm going to make instances. Click in empty space here, hit Ctrl Shift V, and you've got instance of white background. Why? Because if you would like to change the color of the wheel, okay, this part of people will change. That's a very good practice in my opinion. And I'm going to do the same with every background. So I'm going to connect them. And now this, all of this merge, they need to be operator mode at top. On the top, we've got blue background. To make it more visible, we can disable these two merges. So hit Ctrl P, and now I want to mask purple people. Okay, I'm going to make 25% of this population, and that will be another rectangle. So just hit rectangle and hit add in the paint mode, so that we've got 5% and we need 20% more. Adjust this rectangle here. Let's go to the next one, that will be green, and we hit rectangle, and we need 30% here, so that will be 30 people in this case. And the last one is blue. Okay, all is done. Let's go to this merge, hit 2, and make sure you on frame number 50. And we're going to animate all of these rectangles, okay? And I want to select all of them and make it bigger. That's how my workflow looks like. I try, in my composition, I always try to make all nodes which I animate, I try to keep it bigger. So when I come back to the composition, I know what's going on here. Each rectangle on frame 50, you need to hit red diamond next to the center X and Y. And now when we come back to frame number 0, we're going to animate this, so that will be to the right, same as this rectangle will be to the right, and that is green. Let's move it here. That will be animated from here. Maybe that will have a better look. And that will start from the right. And as you can see, this is how it looks like. That's the final result. And just want to smooth this out. You need to hit this to select them and then type F. And I want to ease in to 100. Rest of the composition is just, I want to drop shadow here. I need to glow this up. We need glowy things. We like glowy things. We got drop shadow, we got glow. And I'm gonna do the same here. And we got the final composition like that. And what I want to do is add some filters at the end. I'm going to meet the media pool. I've got overlay here. This is white dust overlay 001. I connect it here, name it dust, and go to merge, make it screen. And I want to put down again, it won't be so obvious. What else I want to drop is blur, and that I want to hit 0.3, let's say. And at the end, vignette. Let's switch off the guides, Control G, and this is final result, guys. Okay, guys, thank you very much for watching. See you in the next one.